The meeting to address road carnage, which was held at the Speaker's chambers, was attended by, among others, officials from the Ministry of Works and Transport, Uganda Police Force, Uganda National Roads Authority, and members of Parliament. While presiding over Parliament, the Speaker Anita Among announced resolutions indicating that the Uganda National Roads Authority has immediately availed about 8 vehicles to rid the roads of abandoned, all broken down vehicles.
UNRWA has immediately offered at least 8 tow vehicles to tow the abandoned vehicles on the roads. That's an immediate action. The Ministry of Works and Transport must expedite the development of regulations to operationalize the Road Act 2019.
The meeting has also agreed to raise down temporary structures within the confines of the road reserves. A road reserve measures 15 meters from the middle of the road to either side and always marked to avoid encroachment.
UNRWA is directed to immediately remove the roadside markets and taxi parks that have encroached onto the roads and road reserves. For example, when you go to Busega, will you even pass? When you go to Lukaya, Kareilwe, Kamocha, all those areas, you go to Kireka, Chalwajala, you see all those areas. There is a main road, but there is a market inside the main road.
Another key resolution that has been for the Ministry of Works and Transport to, in a month's time, table regulations operationalizing sections 57, 58 and 59 of the Road Act 2019 that regard towing off the road abandoned vehicles.
Not everybody has a right of way. Not everybody is supposed to have a siren on his or her car. Not everybody is supposed to have those lead lights on the cars. And what we agreed, this must be immediate.
The Speaker contends that this is the right thing to do in light of recent gruesome accidents that have gripped the nation, such as that of one business tycoon, Apollo Nyegamehe. However, she noted that these directives have often been floated by politicians seeking cheap popularity.
The mistake we make as politicians, we instead go back and tell our people, you do it for the sake of votes. You continue. And yet you know very well that the same voters of yours are going to die of these accidents. So it starts with us, the leaders. Let's talk to the people and make people understand what is good for them in terms of road safety.
Legislators have welcomed the resolutions which aim to circumvent the growing road carnage. They urged government to adequately support and promote road safety interventions in Uganda.
That if a car has gotten a mechanical challenge, there is a car that is available to tow it away.
Compulsory eye testing, because so many people are driving visually impaired. Some are short-sighted, some are long-sighted. They cannot see near or far objects.
Uganda Police Force statistics indicate that over the last 5 years, approximately 10 or more Ugandan lives have been lost on our roads daily, with the highest number being 12 deaths per day as recorded in 2021, an indication that there has been a 13.3% increase from 3,663 in 2020 to 4,150 accidents in 2021. And in 2021 alone, 17,443 people were involved in road crashes. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.